Hi, I'm Ben.
And I'm MP. We love the ocean, so we decided to make it our home by buying a massive wooden schooner, which is unfortunately sinking.
A lot of people believe our boat is doomed, but we refuse to settle on that thought, and we are willing to do whatever it takes to bring it back to its former glory.
Join us on this refurbishing journey and wish us luck. Okay, let's catch up. Our new keel was ready to be installed, but our boat was not ready to receive it, as we ended up finding a lot of rot. In the previous episode, we finished removing our sternpost. Yes, that big piece around the prop shaft is gone. And our mission for this episode is to build a new one, as well as a new forefoot. So, let's do this!
In front of the boat, what's happening is this stencil has been made. And two, I'm going to call them stencils, they're probably called something else if they are, to be on the screen here. This stencil has been made and this, so that is already two frames that are ready to be, well, these stencils are ready to be put on some new pieces of wood to cut out some frames, so that's pretty cool as well. We've still got one, two, at least two remaining of these. What's very cool about this is even though it's plywood, it's looking like progress. So there are moments where everything's just being broken and broken and broken. I mean, look around us. It's like the elephant graveyard from The Lion King, but it's the wood graveyard. And every piece of wood here, even the wood holding up the boat, is from our boat. So it's very nice to see progress, like the keel, all these pieces of plywood mean a nicer boat. So, we would rather not remove wood, but we don't want to hide that we have rot as well. So when we find rot, we're not going to just leave it, because that will just cause problems for later.
To do a refurbish this size, you have two options. Just do a makeup on the boat so it looks nice and you can navigate with no safety. Or you do it properly, which is scary and a lot of work. And
all the way or not at all. And which one is it?
We decided all the way.
All the way.
Aqui, né? Aqui não tinha, que é só o pó daquele DREAMY lá que nós tiramos.
Aqui, fazer um vento aqui, né?
This is the wooden piece that holds the prop shaft in place. And we just received the new wood that's gonna replace it. But the size is not perfect, so they're trying to see a way to make it fit if we need to make a cut or something. So this is what we are studying now. This wooden piece over here is our old coral de proa, the front of our boat. Well, I was looking here now, is even though the wood of choice was a good wood, the piece specifically was not good because it had loads of like knots from the tree. You can see like this is the tree shape, and some parts of the wood are not as solid as the real part of the wood, and that was the problem in a lot of parts of our boat, that they put the white, which is the crust of the tree, also on planks, and that pieces shouldn't be on the boat because they're not as resistant as the wood should be. So looking at this closely, I understand a bit where our problems are coming from, because I know the boat's not old, the wood of choice is good, but of course, those parts plus lack of maintenance created all these problems. But well, here I am with the old one. Let me show you something. Over here, the new piece is getting measured and now cut even. Didn't want to stop working, but Beto came and unplugged his machine because it's a coffee break now, and that's very sacred. So while I was down there having a look at our new piece, this was happening here. Look what I just found. The engine parts have been removed, so we can sandblast them, clean them, paint them, and do whatever we need for them to look nice. And not just look, but also stop rusting and last longer. And so we can have a safer engine. So yeah, this is exciting.
This is some serious millimeter work. So that's one piece being cut. The second piece, that's gonna be cut, comes right here. This line, and that goes there. That part is going to be this piece, massive piece. That part, what is being cut right now, is the piece that's going to be on the front. Over here. So that was the one being cut right now. The piece that will fit on the same piece of wood and will be cut out of that same piece of wood is the piece that will be put there, where those legs are. What's super cool is all the wood that makes the bottom of our boat is there, ready, being cut or being cut. So that means that coral de proa, I need to find the English name for that, the keel has been cut, and the part on the back, I also have to find the English name for it, the part that holds the prop shaft. Then we could just start working our way up, which is super cool.
Probably the last time we are showing this front without this big piece that's missing. So we're really excited. The piece is being cut over there. And yeah, soon all the things we've been working since last week are starting to come to the boat. All the new pieces. But so far, all we see is the structure. We look at the boat and it looks worse every day. But I believe that from this week on, we are going to start having new pieces on, and that will make us more excited and more hopeful about the whole work. So yeah, I'm really happy.
Yeah.
This stuff's going very fast. Beto and Elio working on the part that's going to go on the front of the boat. And we have William and Clayton cutting out the back part of the boat where the prop shaft is going to go through. So stuff is going very fast. When these two parts have been cut, literally everything from the front, which is this one, to the keel, to the back, which is the one over there, is going to be able to be put under the boat, and that's the backbone of the boat finished, and then we can start working our way up, which is super exciting. So right now it's just a very square block. It's gonna have to turn into something with an angle into here, which is not a right angle, which is not gonna be easy. And then there. So this line here represents this line over here, and that has to be cut at the right angle for the planks to be able to be put on the side of the boat. Now this piece has been cut, all that needs to start looking like is the same shape as this old piece here. So they're busy taking measurements. It's looking super exciting because that's going to be under our boat soon. When that's finished, I'm gonna be super chuffed. What's being cut out of the wood for the front part of our boat. This is the old one, and picture this being part of a plank on our hull. So this would be the bottom of the boat, and this would start going up to the nose, to the front of the boat. Now, in order for all the planks to sit nicely, we almost need a right angle here. So the planks, which will be up here, can lean nicely against there, but also close this area. So if it's anything to cut too short, the planks will be sticking out here. If this bit is cut too deep, the whole part, the coral de proa, will be sticking out here. So it's very important that all the way along it is cut the same length. This will be visible on the outside of the boat. This, there will be the piece of wood up against this, the nose. And the keel will be stuck under here, and this bit will all be hidden, and this will be hidden inside the boat. So that's what they're chiseling out over there. Precision work. That's the first time this piece of wood is being tested in the boat. It's not fitting quite as correctly up in that corner, so a little bit is going to be cut off, and that's pretty cool. Pieces in place. There is one piece of wood missing on the front, which is going to join. Well, this is not all good wood, so this is going to be fixed up first or replaced, which is then going to be joined onto here. So the joint is going to be made on here. Same for the back as well. There's going to be a joint made from here, and then also this is all going to be leveled out so this line meets nicely. And then the keel is going to fit nicely under here as well. It's almost fitting incorrectly. There's just tiny, tiny gaps. So Beto is busy cutting away what still has to be cut, so we can close those gaps. No. I literally made the previous video 2 minutes ago and it's already done. Not a single gap anywhere. What is it?
Place.
Maybe now I can explain it better. So now this is in place. This is in the way. See where there's a line here and a line here. I have a better sample of a piece of side wood, which means this has to go against that. But unfortunately, a piece still has to be cut away so that this can keep going all the way down to the back and the boards can be stuck against it, so this should be quite flush. This is where the prop shaft will go after it's been trimmed a bit, because there is a lot about that that still has to be cut. But it's looking good. That's how it works. It gets removed, mud gets put on, sanded, drawings made to make sure it fits, cuts and sanding and chiseling made based on the drawings, and then going to take them back off and back on until it fits correctly. So now it fits nice on both sides and the joint has been cut. This joint has been cut and sanded. to then be joined onto the piece of wood here, which is probably going to be a bit higher up, where it's not as bad.
We have our first piece!
The first new piece on the boat after... everything's been broken down. It's still quite raw, still has to be trimmed and cut, but it's in the boat.
But I love it already!
Yeah.
Mwah. Woohoo!
That's cool. One of many.
It's so small.
Just to explain what this looks like, as you can see what happened behind the ribs, also not so good. Here's where lots of fresh water came in, and it's a pity because we've lost a lot of these frames. They're massive, but we've lost a bit of them already, and a lot of these planks, they're gonna have to be removed. I think there's a hole in our boat over there. And this is where the big hole was, which has already been taken out. It was over there.
This is our new piece, that's only the only thing I can think about. So, finishing the day, I'm exhausted. I don't know why, but if you spend 1 hour in the engine room, it feels like 3 hours doing anything else. It's so tiring over there.
It's a tight area.
But what we did, in the engine room, we finished. But the most important thing that happened today, we have our first new piece in place.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
And Pierre actually did a lot in the engine room. So the mounts, the anti-vibration mounts of the engine that make sure the engine don't vibrate with the engine or whatever, she removed them.
Yeah, not alone. So, I had help from our friend the mechanic.
Yeah.
But I learned a lot today, so.
So MP and our mechanic put the engine down onto plank. Well, rested them on planks and removed the mounts. I'm impressed.
Yeah.
One more thing. If you look over here, that's the old piece of wood that used to hold our propeller through that hole over there. If you look over here, is our new one, which will hold the propeller once a hole has been made through here, which is also pretty cool.
Yeah, very exciting.
Literally the three biggest parts of the bottom of our boat have been made.
Yeah, true.
Front's already in, keel's over there, and the back. Ciao.
Hi. Hey guys, we hope you enjoyed the video.
Yeah, it was very cool for us because our three biggest slash widest pieces of wood, which of course are the hardest to cut, have been made and are located some under the boat right now. So soon we're just going to put the keel on, and then that's going to be like the whole backbone, like you said, is on the boat.
Yeah, this episode was very special for us because we had our first piece of many on the boat already, and that really showed the beginning of our dream really coming true.
So we want to thank everyone who is helping us on Patreon and PayPal by sending a massive thanks, and we hope you enjoy the new lens videos we make, which we just discovered, which is cool.
Yeah.
And yeah, so
yeah, thank you so much for helping us. So
we want to thank
Flight.
Thank you, Mitch.
Brain Cramp.
And Thomas.
Phil and Laura.
Stefan.
Paper.
Jim.
Oi.
The Full Monty.
Connor.
Adam.
Frode.
Or Frody, we're not sure. Let us know. Martin.
And also thank you to the PayPal donations from Ben.
Jürgen.
Terry and Kevin again.
Thanks so much. And Christoph. She's crazy.